Hey guys, Craig here, welcome back to some more Crash Bandicoot Warped. In the previous episode, we finally finished getting all the time relics. I might have uploaded two of those videos a day because, well, they're pretty short and maybe slightly tedious. I'm not sure. I enjoyed doing them. It's the first time I've ever unlocked all of these levels. And today, we are in the heart of the Time Twister. And we've got five new levels to do. And we'll be able to go back to old levels, as you can see, like Hang'em High. And is this an old level as well? Can't remember. Yes, Future Frenzy to get the remaining gems. So, I think the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to do one run, which is a normal level, which is just me going for the box gem. And then I'll do another run, which will be sped up to get the relic. I have heard things about Ski Crazed about it being very difficult. Also, I just realised something. I have that volume on, so I'll be right back. Alright, and I am back. So, time to go on. Sorry, but I forgot that I, because of the way I was recording that before, I wasn't actually talking at all, so, and all, any of my commentary was done in editing. So, basically, I had the full volume on so I could hear the music, just how I normally play. Oh, Frank, let's see how. Oh, God, it's look. Also, if you look, I've got 99 lives. So, I shouldn't get game over. I've not got game over in any of the three games yet. I've completed all of them to their final bosses, at least. Haven't done like two time trials in Crash 2 and none in Crash 1. Although, honestly, Crash 1 is not my favourite Crash game, by far. I'd say I'd be down in the bottom of the lists, honestly. However, I was playing yesterday, because I basically done yesterday from start to finish for a second time ever. It was a lot more enjoyable than the PlayStation 1 version, so I will give it that. But, yeah, almost says this is my first time ever playing this level at all. I've really never seen footage of it either, so that's why I'm pretty shite at the moment. And why I'm getting a bit worried with the fact that 100 boxes, that sounds like quite a lot. Oh no, I just had a thought. Speedrunning this level will be a bitch. Like, look at how much obstacles are all around the place. Like, look at that box. Like, it's basically a jump. Where you have to do a jump, and then you'll have to avoid the bombs as soon as you land. Yeah, so, wish me a bit of luck. But, guys, I just wanted to ask you guys, what do you want after this Let's Play? Do you want me to go on to Crash 1 and 2? Like, immediately? Because I'm getting into it. If I was going to do it, I'd do Crash 1 first, because I'm doing Crash 2 over in the Gaming Dream Team right now. Links down below. Okay, I got hit. Oh yes, I've got double Ukuku as well. But I guess that would help. I forgot I had that. That's actually, it's a pretty good thing then. That I had it. Let's see, we're actually not doing too bad. I thought I was going to much, much worse. Also, I'm going to do like kind of same thing with the time of when I'm going to do speedruns is whenever I've finished all of these levels. Anyway, I think there's only three levels I'll have to speedrun as well. Maybe, you know what, the speedrun part maybe on the finale. Because I can't just do the final boss, because I've already done the final boss. Like, legit, it's just doing the final boss again. Let's have a look here. But yeah, the speedrun in this is going to be horrendous, I think. However, my other flipping jet ski levels went first try, so I'm really happy about how that went, because I'm not good at these levels at all, as you can see. By some, I got, unlike the time trials, I got gold first try in both of them. And yeah, I'm gonna go for platinum, and maybe in the finale I'll show footage of me earning the finally earning the platinum. I'm surprised actually. Shit. Well, going for a platinum on this game. Oh, I'm getting a bit nervous now, boys. Oh dear, this could get bad. This could go bad for girls. Also, I just realized that this is the first level in this secret warp room. But the same thing is, I suck at these types of levels. However, I do think a lot of them are vehicle levels. Like, there's a plane one, I've saw footage of it, and I think you fly through your rings or something like that. Come on. But, hopefully things go well. I was playing Crash 1 for goodness sakes, and that is actually a hard game. And I'm not good at it whatsoever. We can't lose any lives, boys, or else we'll die. We might get game over. Hey, I got that trophy anyway, for 99 lives. That's why I've got this, honestly. It wasn't that I was preparing or anything. I just finished the time trials about an hour and a half ago. I was like, you know what? I've got about 60 lives, or I had 50 or 60 lives. If even, maybe I had 45 or something like that. And then spent about half an hour getting it up to 99, just for a trophy. I don't know how I'm going to get any other games. That is just cruel. Alright guys, and I am back once again. Time to get in this. Look, this could be hard, I think. But honestly, I think this is actually, I can't remember which level it was. I think it was this, and I heard it turned into a meme, but it was so difficult. But honestly, I wouldn't call this meme standard difficulty at all. Oh Frank, I just realized that's an exploding knight. Am I at the end of the level? Really? But I wouldn't call this meme level difficulty, honestly. I'd say this is just decently difficult. I'd say it's actually a good difficulty. I wouldn't even say this is an extremely hard level. Let alone meme standard. I'm wondering if it was a different level they're talking about. Like, I understand maybe for time trials this is going to be a pain in LR, so. Trying to figure out how, what the best way to do this is. So just drive right here. Let's have a look. Alright, there we go. That was easier than I thought it was going to be, and we're back up to 99 leaves. I'm just going to blow myself up while doing this here. Up. Box. There we go, boys. As easy as that. So here we go, just to mess up the rest of us here. I'm not going to do any of these jumps if I don't need to, because it's just more and more of a risk. This actually might be a bit of a risk going through here. Okay, no, I can't get out the other side. I was worried about because I had to turn around or something like that. But here we go. Even if I die after I collect these two boxes, hopefully I don't. There we go. Yeah, I was hoping if I did die, it would be after I collected the gems, so I wouldn't have to collect their boxes again. There we go. I wouldn't call that too bad, actually. Am I still 99 lives, or am I just under 99, like a couple of wampa fruit? But honestly, I went better than I thought. It was 11 minutes, recording-wise, but that's minus cuts and me syncing the video and audio, so probably was about 6-7 minutes. There we go. There's a gem gotten. I'm pretty happy if my... Oh shit, I forgot. I apologize for skipping that one gem. But also, I don't even need to go out for any boxes here, but I've got a feeling this is just going to be crammed full of nitro like you wouldn't believe. Like, there's going to be like 100 or something nitro here for me to avoid, because, yeah. Also, but like, I love the way they put in that first part, but like, yeah, as I thought. Oh, yeah, but I forgot. Now I know that's so hard, because you don't even need to beat the game to get to this area here. So you might not have the bazooka, which is probably going to save my arse this entire time and make this overly easy to a point. Because, yeah, all you need is 10 relics to get to this point. Don't need to be gold, don't need to be platinum, we don't need to be anything. So basically at this point, also yeah, you may not even have unlocked, well actually no, you would have had to unlock, you pretty much would have had to unlock the double jump, so. I guess that you would need the double jump to get past that part there, but I don't find this too hard. Like, there we go, there's the whole level done apparently. Wow. Okay, I was expecting it to be a bit harder than that, however. But, well, all went well. And there's our last color gem. Ha! Well, guys, that went better than I thought it was going to be. As I said before, because we've got all the power-ups, you're a wee bit overpowered once you get to this part. A wee bit overpowered if you're at the same point as I am. But there we go. Got all the colored gems now in Crash Bree. And hype. And I'll show off this. I think that's actually world 200%. Did I get all gold here? Gold. Oh, I may have got sapphire here. No, I've got gold. I feel like I've got sap. No, I don't. Because I remember I got goldness here. Yeah. There's. Oh, is that even world 2? Is that world 4? Yeah, it's world 2. Don't waste 4, I meant 3. But there we go. And now we're back down to the core. The time twister. And here's a fun looking level. A racing level. Uh-huh. So I'm a bit worried about this one, honestly. There's one level I'm worried about, it's this one. But we aren't going for... You don't have to get first, do you? Not, at least not getting the gems. For time trials, you'll have to get first. But since I'm only going for gems this episode, like, I'm not too worried. Like, I've saw footage of this place, and that's why I'm a bit more worried about it, because I know how dark and all it is. But honestly, I'm not too worried about it, because I think that if I go for these boxes pretty slowly, it shouldn't be too bad. I'm even going to avoid these speed boosts and all, because, yeah, there's just no point to go for it. And I actually... Oh, bollocks! I got it somehow, I didn't think I got it. But yeah, I really like these levels, honestly. Let's have a look. Where is my beautiful boxes? Let's see, only 6, damn. I'm not gonna lie to you, this is pretty difficult to see where everything is. Obviously. I know that's intentional, but this is gonna make things a bit harder to get the boxes. Like, it's hard enough whenever you can see the entire course, let alone nothing. Like, No! Ah, there we go, got them all. I'm somehow in 5th now. How am I in 5th? I'm not even trying. How slow are the UFOs because you can't see them? Ah, shit, that's avoiding the entire thing. Luckily, you don't get... How bad would it be if you fell down there and lost a life? I can't remember, did that on the original? Because I thought you did lose a life, but... Now I think about it, more I think about it, I don't think you did. I don't think you lost a life. I think... I don't know what I'm trying to say. Let's have a look here. 1, 2. Okay, we're over halfway, so... Hopefully the cut... The only reason... I'm not really doing anything interesting. I'm talking about anything interesting because my full concentration is making sure I don't miss any boxes. Like this one could have been really easy to miss. So let's have a look here. Police car. Shit. And even whenever I go on these boosts, I'm not trying to boost. Oh. Shit. Okay, so. 23. I thought I got 23 there. I was about. That's why I was like, what the? I was literally thinking to myself, how have I missed a box? I did not miss a box. But I didn't. There we go. Area 51 complete. Oh, wait, did this one have 2 gems? Did this one have 2 gems? Now I think about it. Because if it did, that means I have to come first. I was wondering why that wouldn't be a thing. Yeah, it does have 2 gems. So that means I'll see you guys all in a wee second, and of course I'll speed that up for you, so you don't have to watch the same level again, because it's pretty long. So I'll be right back. And there we go, boys. Also did the time trial at the same time that I got gold. Is that platinum? I have never gotten platinum before. Was that actually platinum? Holy moly, I have not gotten platinum ever in Crash Bandicoot. So, that was worthwhile to do a time trial at the same time. Because I knew because I had to come first, I needed to get good time. So I went for a time trial at the same time. I made a couple of big mistakes there. How did I get platinum? Yeah, I was 100% platinum as well. So there we go. Can't do any better than that level. Why the frig did I get platinum? I'm even gonna pause it just to make sure. Let's have a look here. Yep, I got platinum. Not complain though. I'm not going to complain. But here we go, we can get like all of world 6, I guess, done. I don't know where the final two relics come from. But I got a feeling it's from the secret exits I haven't gotten. There's probably two extra levels that I've never even heard about before. Because I didn't even know there were secret exits until I looked at the trophy list. So I'm like, yeah, there's a couple of secret levels I haven't done yet. So that's going to be fun. And alright, as always, I'm going to abuse this bazooka whenever I can. So there we go. Yeah, I'm a bit worried because I've never done this part of a level before, which is might be a bit more difficult. So, wish me luck. But I'm so happy I got all the colored gems now. That's going to make things 10 times easier for everybody. Also, is that already a checkpoint? Wow. I was not expecting to get the checkpoints this quickly. I don't think this level is honestly going to be too hard. I think it's kind of going to be like the other platforming level in World 5, which was to get the yellow gem, and you saw how easy that was, honestly. I'm surprised that these aren't too bad so far. Like, I'm really surprised about how easy I found everything in this world so far. Like, even Area 51, that one, it took me my 2 tries, I think, and then I got platinum whenever I did. Also, wow, there's a gem already. So we have already done the hard part. So, exactly as I thought, it wasn't going to be too hard. And that means all I've really got left to do is that plane level, and I think it's worth 2 gems as well. Let me have a look. We've got, after this level, we'll have 30 gems, which is an insane number. Let's see. Oh my word, we have to go back. Because if I remember, there's like gems, like, I mean, boxes the entire way back, which means we're gonna have to backtrack straight to the start of the level. And I think that's where I'm gonna cut to, so I'll be right back. Alright then, we're back here. So let's have a look around. Because I know I had one more question mark thing. I just got electric shock by my own arm. That makes no sense. But we're not here to make sense, are we? Wait, this isn't the level I'm thinking about, I don't think. But you know what? We'll have to go back anyway. I honestly don't think this is the level I was originally thinking it was. Because I'm thinking about it, I wouldn't have had the bazooka at this point and I needed it. I think that's the one with the transparent blocks. But now I'm thinking about it. Boxes, I mean. But now I'm thinking about it, it isn't, so. Yeah, but it isn't a waste of time to go back here because, well, as you can see, there's a load of shite back here. So, yeah, it's weird to go through level backwards. I'm going to have to say that. It is weird to do this. Bang. I know exactly. I think I'm actually near the start of a level now because I know exactly what level this is. This isn't actually that hard of a level either, so. Once I've done this part, I may have shown off all the level other than this, so after I've done this, it shouldn't be too hard. And here's the start of the level, so I'm going to just cut back to whenever I've gotten a clear gem. Or if, but I'm just basically showing here that you can backtrack the entire way back to here. But I'm either going to cut back till the clear gem, or if there's like a a color gem right I haven't done yet. So I'll see you guys all in a second. Guys, I just want to point out something. Without using the nitro crate, we have already gotten all the boxes and levels. So that was a fake explosion. And there we go, got two clear gems now, which, you know what, makes everything so much better. I'm surprised actually how well we've done everything. Like, guys, be proud of me. Bruh. Look how far we've gotten. There we go, I think that's pretty much World 4 completely done as well. I know there's a few color gems I haven't done, so color gem paths I haven't done, which will unlock us a couple of gems per level. So, but look at that. There's Future Frenzy 100% done now. We'll never have to do a level ever again. We'll probably play it in the future. And 30 out of 45 gems. Like, we are so close to the end. Like, once we've done this episode, I think next episode may be like the penultimate episode, where we get 15 gems. 13 actually scratched. I'm sorry, I lied. 13. Oh, and I think this is also a race, is it? Is this a race? That's it. Yeah, it is actually. Oh, why did I do that? Win the race by going for each ring in order. Oh, this controls like a wee bastard. I'm not gonna lie, this does not control the best. So it looks like I'm gonna be trying to do the time trial accidentally first. So that means I'm also gonna be doing the time trials this episode. Like, should I do the other Cocoa time trial if I've accidentally started this one because I thought it was a box? Also, how am I supposed to win this race? Why do I win this race? Okay, so do you have to? Yeah. So, I'm supposed to be speeding my way through these, I think. And you go faster through the rings whenever you spin, is that it? Let me see, do I go faster when I do this? Yeah, but I don't do it go as fast whenever I do it. Okay. Okay, I understand, I gotcha. Because I just remembered I saw that symbol in the first ring, so I was like, maybe I should try it. Oh, yeah, but I just realized something. There's no way in hell I'm going to be getting this time trial now, is there? Yeah, this is going to be one of those ones where I cut the entire level. I'm just going to do this wee version here, and then I'll show you a sped up version, which is the one that will actually probably count towards all of the gems. Oh my good god, this controls so badly. There's no way. If I've gotten a normal relic for now, I'm gonna take it. For the time trial, for the entire let's play, I'll take it. Even if I get a normal gem this way, this can't be that hard, the time trial. Let's see also. Look. Is there supposed to be a better way to control this, or am I just... I know I'm sucking, so you don't have to tell me how much. But even level design's pretty shit as well. Like, I know it's probably on purpose, but like, come on. Yeah, I knew I was not gonna get a time trial at all for that. So, restart trial, yeah. So I'm gonna just show you a speed up of me winning the race, and obviously you don't need to see. I'll be going really slowly, so you won't have to see me doing the boxes. And there's the first gem gotten, and I think honestly I was playing for it, and I've gotten better each time I've done this. So I honestly don't think after our last try. Even though I wasn't going for first at all, so I think you realized. I don't think it'll be too bad getting first, honestly. I hope. Says the person who hasn't come before third at all yet. But here we go. I'll cut right back. I'll also be going for a time trial at the same time because there's no point not to. And there we go. Gold and got the gem. Perfect. That was two tries later. My last try before this, I lost after the first ring. So I was like, you know what? Screw it. Restart. There we go. I wasn't actually as bad as I thought it was going to be. Once you know how to control it, and once you know there's a break, this level becomes so much easier. I did not know that the airplane had a break. For the life of me, I did not know it. There we go. That's pretty much all of these levels done. Like, the only one I haven't, like, fully done relic-wise is the first one of Coco. Like, if you actually look here, all of them even have gold, I think. Which is amazing. Oh, no. Oh, it's got platinum, I was about to say. It's only got silver. I forgot I got platinum, actually. But okay, with that, I'll be right back because I'm just gonna go get a relic on this level here. Let's see, how did that go? Ah, it was only a normal relic, but that's all we need for 100%. So you know what? If I'm going to go for gold and all, which I am, but that's for a later date, I'll do those in a different episode. That took me 53 minutes to do all of these levels. Minus fact, I'm cutting a lot of them down. I mean, a lot of them are being cut down. Like, let's see. The first level is being cut down, second level isn't because it was really short. Third level's being cut down, fourth level's being cut down, fifth level's being cut down, that's being sped up. So you know what? I don't think that was too bad. So that's all of these levels down here complete. We don't have to return down here ever again the entire Let's Play. So that's all of those levels done, which I was worried about. I thought they were going to be really hard. And people said that Coco War Ski thing was meaningly hard to me once. So if it is, apparently I'm just good at it. But look, we're 90% there. So with that, thank you guys all so much for watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. And hopefully see you guys all next time. Where we're trying to go get 9% of our 90 done. So hopefully see you guys all then. Bye.